A very good evening to you. Thank you for joining us. Welcome to Sports Tonight. This is the Thursday night edition of the show. Promises to be exciting, fun-filled, and very loaded as well. My name is Tony Bito. I'd like to start off the show tonight by saying thank you to you for joining us, and also promise you that if you stay with us for the next 15 minutes that we're bringing Sports Tonight to you, we'll make sure that you enjoy every bit of it. And of course, do what we love to do, which is to talk sports and update you with the goings-on, both on the domestic scene and on the international scene. But tonight, I want to start off the show by introducing Wale Adigun. Wale is always with us on Thursdays, and Wale is here once again to talk sports. And essentially, we'll be focusing on football, a little bit of athletics, and maybe a little bit of basketball as well. Foreign, on the foreign scene, that is, because we also should be going to Washington to hook up with Sonny Young, who will be also giving us his own beat on the show tonight. It's a Thursday. There's going to be a lot of domestic basketball to talk about. Femi Adefeso, and a special guest. She was here about 2-3 weeks ago. She's back here. She'll be joining us. We'll be taking a look at the ongoing DStv Premier Basketball League Final 8 that's going on in Lagos. Of course, we'll also be talking Copa America, Centenario, and Euro 2016 that is now at the quarterfinal stage. Wale Adigun joins me on Sports Tonight. Wale, good to have you on Sports Tonight this Thursday.
Good to be back, Tony. Hope you've been well too.
Yeah, thank God everything is going well, and I'm sure we're going to have a good show tonight. So just stick around with us. But let's tell you what you need to do. Very quickly, before we roll to the next part of the show, by means of feedback, we're going to be very, very heavy on feedback tonight because we want you to talk to us. There are a lot of issues that you will need to talk to us about on the program tonight. So feedback is going to be very key. For those of you who watch us all the time, you know how to do it. But for the sake of those who are watching us for the very first time, we are going to tell you how you can be a part of Sports Tonight, how you can give us your own thoughts, your opinion, your reaction, what you feel around about issues that we discuss on the program tonight. That's it on your screen. Feedback platforms, Facebook, channels, iPhone Sports, on Twitter, channels underscore sports, which is for channel sports, and of course my handle at Tony underscore Bitway. All of these will be active tonight, so we want you to talk to us and follow us as we go along on the show. Let's also tell you that wherever you are, you can be a part of what we're doing on the show. You can watch us on our website, www.channelstv.com, youtube.com/channelsweb as well. You can watch us seamlessly there and track all that we're doing on the program tonight. To watch us on your iPad, your iPhone, your BlackBerry, it's as simple as clicking on m.channelstv.com. And if you download the Channels app for iOS, Windows, Android, from their respective stores, it even gets better for you because that means you're keeping Channels at your fingertips. You are on to your home for the news 24/7. It's so close to you. You can track everything that goes on your award-winning Channels television tonight. And as you do all of that, please don't forget to tell us where you're watching us from, just to help us to appreciate you a little more. Know what impact we are also making with our show. All right, so that's the feedback for the program tonight and what we want you to do for us. Let's start off the show by quickly going to South Africa before I bring Wale in on a few issues. South Africa, Durban to be precise, is where the African Senior Athletics Championship is going on. For Team Nigeria, some of our best athletes, top athletes, are not there. I'm talking about someone like Blessing Nokagbare. She's not there. Shehe Ogunlewe, who is Nigeria's fastest man, is also not there. A few of our top athletes are not there. But some other athletes are there representing Nigeria. Let's just see if we can quickly get you up to speed with some of the updates coming out of that championship. It's the second day now, and we've been able to pick a few medals here and there. But South Africa look like they're dominating that event already. Stephen Mosia won bronze for Nigeria in the men's discus and shot put, which is good. 2 bronze medals in that one. Miles Okauma has qualified for the men's 400 meters hurdles. for the final. He finished fourth in E2 and was one of the best qualifiers. Chidi Okezie has also qualified for the 400 meters final for men. He finished second in E2 of the semifinals. We have Gloria Asumnu placing fourth in the women's 100 meters final in a time of 11.45 seconds. The Ivorian lady, the queen of the tracks, the newest record holder for Africa, Muriel Aure, is the African champion with a time of 11 flat. She ran 11 seconds flat. And of course, Patience George has also qualified for the women's 100 meters final that will be taking place tomorrow. Blessing Okagbare is not there, and a few of our other top athletes are not there, but this is, for me, good preparation for the Olympic Games. Although the time that they are returning doesn't look like Olympic standard yet, but at least these athletes can begin to warm up to some tougher challenges in the weeks ahead. Yeah, that's it. We'll keep updating you. We'll talk more about that tomorrow. Hopefully by tomorrow we'll have an idea of a lot more from Team Nigeria and how well we're performing in Durban. That we'll be doing for you on the show tomorrow. Let's come to football very quickly. Tomorrow is very crucial for Africa, for Nigeria, because the World Soccer Governing Body have directed that on Friday, the 24th of June, the draw for the third and the final round of the 2018 World Cup qualifiers will take place in Cairo. So for Nigeria, the 2018 World Cup qualifiers, the Super Eagles, will be knowing their opponents in that third and final round. We are going to have five groups of four teams each, and only the group winners will get a chance to represent Africa at the 2018 FIFA World Cup Russia. Yesterday we gave you the story that no special rankings after the rankings released by FIFA on the 8th of June. And that's what you see on your screen. And we said it on the show yesterday, the teams in the same pot will not be drawn in the same group. So that means Nigeria in pot 2 will not have as opponents Cape Verde Islands, Egypt, Congo DR, or Mali. But you can draw any other team from any other pot. All right, so that's what it looks like for the 2018 World Cup qualifiers, and it will be taking place tomorrow. Wale Adigun, let me bring you in very quickly on this one. I've been reading a lot on social media. People have been fasting and praying. They want to avoid some certain teams, but you never know which team will turn out to be mincemeat for you.
Yeah.
So you have to be careful what you pray for.
You have to be careful what you wish
for. Just be ready to take everybody on, do the business, and be one of Africa's best five. That's what you have to do.
It's as simple as ABC, not complicated as some people's tactics.
What kind of draw are you looking forward to?
I'm looking forward to, see, it's going to be a difficult pathway. Whatever easy or whatever we want to call it, this is going to be probably Nigeria's most difficult path to a World Cup. It is official, because you look at those teams in the mix, except for the teams in our pot, they are difficult teams. I know there are teams we can beat, but they are difficult teams on
there are teams team. We can beat, and there are teams that can beat us.
It's very simple. Very simple.
So
I remember, Antoine, it's not about beating teams. It's also about being perfect in two legs. There are six games where you have to be perfect. Not near perfect. You have to be very, very perfect. And it's a draw that might give Nigeria three North African teams. Mm. That is Tunisia, Morocco, or Libya. And also, it's a draw that can also feature three teams who have been to the World Cup previously, according to what FIFA have told us. So we should be expecting something very, very interesting tomorrow. But for Nigeria, no team will represent anything easy for us, not with the state our football is right now. Gone where it is, where we'll do the business wherever in Nigeria, maybe Liberty Stadium, whatever, and go do the business away from home and qualify. These days, we have to go through difficult
ways. Well, the 2006 World Cup in Germany presented us with the easiest of groupings.
And we messed it up.
We didn't qualify.
We messed it up. Angola, Rwanda, and Zimbabwe.
Yeah, and we've had some very difficult groups. We qualified. So for me, the harder, the better.
The harder, the better.
When we draw very difficult teams, everybody sits up.
I agree
People
with you.
Write us off, and that's when we're at our best.
Yeah, but also sometimes you just need some teams to just, just season through. Because honestly, see, the truth of the matter is, the current state we are right now, are we ready to take on a team like Algeria in Port 1? Algeria are probably the best team in Africa right now. They're playing some fantastic football.
Are you ready to take on Ghana? that, South African rivals, those
I know, but see,
can you take on Cote d'Ivoire?
I don't prefer anybody in here, but anybody we get, we should be prepared to sit up. See, the truth of the matter is that we are not even doing ourselves a favor. How can we be approaching a World Cup qualifier that starts in October and we don't have a coach? Almost all the teams here have a coach. We don't have a coach. We don't even know.
We have a coach. We have a standing coach.
a standing coach.
Well, but I get your point, which is to tell the Nigerian Football Federation to make up their mind.
Yes,
what they want
it
to
has
do.
To be.
If
it
the
has
man,
to be.
Well, we can say it's still October. And October is a long time away.
See, it has to be defined because critically, there's just only one FIFA free day before October.
September.
Is it September? October, August?
September.
Yeah. So there's just one more. So that means the window to get prepared in terms of team chemistry, in terms of assembling a team, is very, very, very small. So we have to start now.
Yeah. Just to buttress your point, the only window that we have to continue to put our team together is in September when we play Tanzania in the Nations Cup qualifier. That is not holding anything for any of us. We are not going. They are not going. Egypt have already picked the ticket from our group. But then we played Mali last month. We played Mali last month. Because it was 27th of May and 31st of May.
Yeah.
So we played Mali and Luxembourg. And what the NFF said was that we were using those games to begin to put our squad together. And for me, Salisu Yusuf, Imama Amakwakabo, Kennedy Boboye, brought in a bunch of young boys that gave us a semblance of what we can do. We beat Mali, dominated that game, could have beaten them hands down, thoroughly embarrassed them even in that game. And they have a French coach who has been with the team for 4 years. Mm. I think we can build on that in September with the game against Tanzania to get us better prepared for the World Cup qualifier starting October. But it all depends on the Nigerian Football Federation.
It's easier said than done. Mm. How about we have a new coach comes in and says, hey,
it starts afresh.
This is what I want. I can only work with players like this. But I would have loved if the NFF had if they had the courage to go with Salisu Yusuf. This guy knows the team. In fact, you know that when Olise left or absconded, so to say, in quotes.
He resigned
for those two matches. I thought it was Salisu Yusuf should have taken that job of those two games in Egypt, home and away. Not Samson Siasia, because it's the natural heir to the job if Sonny Olise leaves. I think Salisu Yusuf has even passed his test. He passed in flying colors against Mali and Luxembourg. Some have even questioned the quality of opposition, but I don't care. You've won a game and you've won it really convincingly well. Abba gets that job to take us to the World Cup. The signs are good. You mentioned the players. And the only thing is that we have a coach who can continue with these players, continue using these players. And see, it's just a matter of time. Whatever group we get, the most important thing is that we can have a clear direction of where we're going to. And if we have that, I think that
we'll keep this conversation going. We'll go on a quick break, we'll come back, but we'll keep this going. Another plus for us, Wale, is that we have this same set of boys. Most of them will be going to the Olympic Games with Samson Siasia.
Yeah.
So they are going to be playing, hopefully, we'll be playing about 6-7 games. That's if we play up to
the final.
The final. 6-7 games to further help us to bond this team together for the World Cup qualifiers. But we have to take advantage of all of these things before the World Cup qualifiers begin in October. We'll keep talking about this, and we want you to join us. But let's just pause for a short time out, and we'll be back with more for you on Sports Tonight.